morning. Talking low because it is like 7:15 in the morning and my friend is still sleeping. I have like 10 minutes to get ready to go and call an Uber. I am here in Orlando for 7 days, 6 park days, and this is my only non-Disney park. So if you want all the Disney content, subscribe. I'll have a lot of Disney vlogs coming. But yeah, I'm just gonna finish getting ready and call an Uber. Here's the outfit with these shoes. This little cardigan thing I'm probably gonna take off at some point. It's really light, but this shirt is a tank top, so if it gets too hot, all my mess. We made it. You have no idea how excited I am right now. Okay, my first park is going to be Islands of Adventure. I want to, obviously, Velocicoaster and the Hulk. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I also definitely want to check the shops. I don't think I did that much last time either. And I didn't eat anything in this park besides a pretzel. So we might try and get like an actual meal this time. So we'll see about that too. But I'm probably gonna need a sun visor because it's gonna be quite warm and sunny today. Okay, I'm in. There's me. I'm gonna start to the right. I don't know if that's a bad decision, but I really wanna ride Velocicoaster. So I'm going this way. I'm gonna walk through Seuss Land, Dr. Seuss Land, is that what it's called? Seuss Landing. Well, this is exciting. Oh my goodness, I've only been on this once. So hopefully today I'll get on a couple times. Coaster was 75 minutes and the single rider was not open yet, so now I'm in Hogsmeade. I'm not mad. I'll go back to it. I don't know if I'm reading this correctly, but this says a 15-minute wait, so let's try that. I was able to do single riders. I waited no time at all. And then Flight of Hippogriff, which is the smaller little roller coaster, was 50 minutes. So that's a no. I would only ride that if it was like 20 minutes or less, for sure. I've always wanted to buy something from here. I don't know if I'm going to yet because I don't want it to melt. But let's go take a look. Cookies and cream fudge that I wanted to get. They also have the salted caramel and butterbeer. I might stop back later. Got my butterbeer. Well, Hagrid's is not opening single rider and the line is 80 minutes, so I'm gonna go wander around the rest of the park. I'll come back to this later. Every time I'm in either side of Harry Potter, whatever, Hogsmeade, I get a butterbeer. I hate butterbeer. Every time I get it, I'll take 2 sips and I want to throw up. But this was like $9 something, almost $10. And that's about it. Okay, I'm gonna try Velocicoaster one more time while I'm over here. And if not, I'm gonna move on. Maybe try the Hulk and again, that whole superhero area that I haven't done. It's only, I think it's like 9, so I've only been here for an hour. I've got plenty of time to explore. I'm walking through the Jurassic Park area. Seems pretty, oh, the screams of the Lost Coaster. Wish that was me. It's cute, they have a Camp Jurassic. We're about to pass, what the heck is it called? the water ride. There is a Kong right here that I have ridden before, and I don't really feel the need to ride again. So I'm gonna skip that, even though it is a 10-minute wait, so not too bad. Toon Lagoon. I've definitely been over here, but oh yeah, it has that water ride. Oh no, I don't know about that. That's a lot of water. I just turned my head and saw these. They're so cute. Look at them. The gin. Oh my gosh, donkey. That's so funny. They also have minions over there. This whole area is so detailed. It's so cute. A little photo op. I personally am a big roller coaster person, so I would get on basically anything. I'm excited. I see the Hulk. I'm just very excited to try all of these. Oh my gosh. I'm so happy to be here. I just passed Spider-Man and I decided to skip it. It's a 3D motion simulator ride, and after having that Butterbeer, I am gonna pass. Okay, let's try this one. A 15-minute wait. Oh my god! This is so great. There are no lockers for this one, but he said there are cubbies at the top, so. Ooh! I'm kind of nervous. Next up is Hulk. They don't have sun visors. I've reached the front of the park again. Okay, I am back in Seuss Landing. So this time around, I'm gonna take it a little bit slower. Hopefully some more of the single rider lines are open. But I also wanna take a look in the shops and see treats. I should probably eat something, like a snack soon. Oh, this area is so cute! If I ran the zoo, that's cute. Ooh, okay, looks like they have snacks right here. Cats, hats, and things. And a gift shop. That could be good. Look at this trash can, stop it. I want one. This is too cute with Mr. Lorax here. They have an ice cream shop. It doesn't look like it's open. Ooh, they have like ice cream sticks, something like that. Okay, I have decided to skip any of the rides in Seuss Landing because I did not know. I thought the park closed at 8, but I guess it closes at 6. So it's 10:18 right now. I'm gonna head back over into Hogsmeade and see if single rider is open yet. I'm really hoping it is, because I still need to hop over to the other park. I'm glad I got like Hulk done and the Doom ride. I'm never gonna remember what it's called. The Doom ride did that. Hagrid's and Velocicoaster are just about the same wait time, so I think I'd rather wait for Velocicoaster. So I'm gonna head back over. Luckily, those areas are right next to each other, so I'm not going too far. And the whole park is basically a big circle, so you're just making loops. So I think I'm gonna do Velocicoaster. Oh my gosh, Velocicoaster went up to 100 minutes. I'm just gonna wait. I have my book, so I'm getting on this ride. I will tell you that much. I just got off. It was a pretty accurate wait time of 1 hour and 30 minutes. the bottom, like once you put your stuff in the locker and the line upstairs went by really fast, but before that kind of dragged, but yeah, I just read my book, but oh my gosh, I love that ride so much. I just kept thinking, this is great. Here's what you missed. Hagrid's single rider opened up, so I like dropped myself in the locker and got in there. But I was literally in line for 35 minutes. Why did I wait that long? I don't know. But I was in line for 35 minutes and we moved maybe 5-10 feet. So I forfeited and got out of line. And then I was going to take the Hogwarts Express over to the other park. And it's a 25 minute wait, which is not that bad, but I'm kind of on a crunch for time now. So I'm heading to the front of the park and I'm just gonna walk out and over. That might take more time, but in my head, I'm making better progress. I've ridden the Hogwarts Express going that way before, so I know what it's about. Also, I did pick up a Butterbeer, not the fudge, a Butterbeer caramel. So I have that and I'll probably eat it in line somewhere. I would really like a hat, a sun visor, but all they have are hats and that's not gonna fit over my hair. Root beer floats are one of my favorite park snacks, so I got one of those. It's just in a regular drink cup, which is kind of weird, but you know, whatever does the trick. I found one. And it's plain pink, which is amazing, so I can wear it everywhere. I think one that said Universal in like the pink embroidery would have been cute too, like they have in the hat. But I didn't find one. So, sun visor, $16. Whatever. I needed it. It's worth it. I'm kind of winded after eating. There was so much ice cream in that root beer float, which is definitely appreciated. I only have 5 hours left. This is my only day at Universal, so I have to try and hit all the marks today. If I don't, obviously, it's not the end of the world. I'll come back. But I wanted to come before Epic Universe, that park, came out. What is that ride? I wanna go on that. Oh, is that Riptide Rocket? Oh, that's Riptide Rocket. I definitely wanna go on that. We are in. We've got the Universal store, all the Minion stuff, Despicable Me. I want to head straight over to Riptide Rocket. You know what it's called. Because I definitely want to do that. And then I want to head over to Diagon Alley. Diagon Alley! This shop is so cute. Very my style. I think I'm, oh, right here. I can go straight up. I've ridden this ride once. It was still during like COVID restrictions, so we still had to wear our masks, but I was sitting like front row and my mask just like moved, just kept sliding up over my face, so I couldn't see a thing. So here's round two. It says it's a 15 minute wait and that is amazing. So I'm just gonna put my stuff in the locker and then head in line. I'm sure I look as disheveled as ever. That ride goes pretty fast. My hair clip was falling on my hair, which is impressive. And I did get first row. Fun fact, they have a single rider line, which I didn't know, but it didn't take long anyway. Yeah, just about 10 minutes, so that was great. I probably want to go on again a little bit later, but I am going to force myself to eat something and get more water. I have a liquid IV that I might pop into my water bottle, but yeah, on days like this when I just like want to get so much done because I have limited time, I just like skip eating, which is not good. Especially in the heat like this. So I'm gonna try and find like a Caesar salad or something, something with chicken in it. I don't really want anything hot. Yeah, I'm gonna look around and see what's here. This park is honestly so pretty and like open and nice. I really enjoy it. There's Christmas shop, so cute. One day, I'm gonna pass on Transformers because I have that at home. What? Marilyn Monroe? And Gabby from somewhere. I know her name's Gabby. We are heading into Springfield, USA. All the Simpsons stuff. And fun fact, I have never seen an episode of The Simpsons, so I don't know what any of this stuff means, but I'm hoping they have food. Krusty Burger, maybe. Well, they had every other food besides salad. So, I mean, I can't really have burgers or...
They come out right here.
I can have pizza sometimes and chicken tenders sometimes. But they also have, oh my goodness, they also have like tater tots and fries and all that stuff, which I don't eat, so, I mean, I know I'm at a theme park, and that's what theme park food is, but you would think someone had a salad somewhere. My first time here, I was looking for Diagon Alley, and I saw the triple decker bus and I was like, okay, obviously I'm close. And I kept seeing people walk through this area right here. And I thought that it was like the restrooms. So it took me a minute to realize this is where I wanted to be.
We did a research meal and checked out.
We're waiting for the dragon. Escape from Gringotts is only a 35-minute wait. I'm not sure if the single rider is open. Let's take a look. It looks like it is, so I guess I'll put food on hold a little longer. Lasted this long. It is very, very crowded right now in Diagon Alley. Not much to eat over here. It's just a lot of pushing and shoving. It's making me a bit nervous. So I rode the ride, which is what I wanted to do. I think I'm gonna head out of this area and find something to eat. I just need to like sit, throw out trash from my purse, like charge my phone, get water, all those things. So I think I'm gonna do that. I've come into this little shop. I don't know what it's called. San Francisco Pastry Company. And they do have a few options as well as all of these treats. I think I'm gonna get this one, the Asian chicken salad. I got the Asian chicken salad with a chocolate mocha cake. And I'm here. I've got my liquid IV that I'm gonna put into my water, the chocolate punch, and wet wipes. Thank goodness I brought these. So I'm gonna sit. I'm under a thing, so I'm not in the sun, but this fan is not really doing much. So it's still quite warm, but I'm just gonna sit and relax for a bit. I am feeling both exhausted and refreshed at the same time. That salad was honestly really good. I ate the whole thing. The cake, I did not enjoy too much. That's just me. Like, it was a good cake, but I don't know. When I looked at it, I thought hazelnut, even though it says mocha. And I just didn't want to taste mocha. So it's in my purse. I could have sat in that little area for the rest of my time here, but figured I better get up and get moving. So I'm gonna see if I can catch any live entertainment. Maybe go on live entertainment. Louie's Bar and Grill. Looks like they have like actual food, but they also have gelato. That's nice.
As of course, background talent, you are responsible for all the crowd reactions. You're responsible for shooting. Yeah. Oh, we're all being
permitted. Haven't been over to this area yet. There's SpongeBob with Patrick right inside. Gonna take photos. I'm heading over to ET, which I believe is in this back corner over here. Hopefully the line isn't too long. It's become very cloudy, which has been very helpful for the heat. It says 15 minutes. Amazing, I'll take it. That was a cute little slow ride. I don't know, there's a troll. I don't know the last time I watched E.T. It was probably when I was an infant child. So I don't actually know the storyline. But we saved E.T. and we saved their planet. I don't know how, but they did. And they personally thanked all of us. So that has to mean something. We are gonna ride the Twirlin' Whirl, the Whirlin' Twirl. One of those. Because why not? It's 5 minutes.
Their face.
Okay, so here is the dealio. I have an hour and a half until park closing. My options are, I was gonna ride Men in Black, but it closed, like it broke or something, it shut down. So I can either go ride Riptide Rocket one more time, they have a single rider, or I can take the Hogwarts Express back to Hogsmeade and try and go on Hagrid's, and then also try and go on Velocicoaster one more time. And I don't know which I can do in an hour and a half. What are my priorities? I think I'm gonna try and take the train back over because I would really like to ride Velocicoaster one more time. And I haven't ridden Hogsmeade. Nope, I haven't ridden Hagrid's. So yeah, I think that's good. I think one time on my Riptide Rocket is okay for me. So I'm gonna try and head over to the other park again. I saw a video that said if you walk to the back side of the triple decker bus, you can kind of see better inside. You can. Very tight squeeze in here. I don't know how comfy that would be with this thing rocking around everywhere. I'm not taking the train because it was an hour wait. Oh, the mummy. Oh, shoot. Forgot about that ride. Oh, it looks like it's closed anyway. Okay, cool. So now I'm really busting missions and I have to walk out of the park and over to the other one again. And it is 4:36. I don't have too much hope in getting both rides done at all. Well, that plan was a fail. I am here in Honey Dukes because the Velocicoaster Sing Rider never opened and lines way too long, and Hagrid's is the same as before. It's not moving at all, so I am just going to head on out. I'm actually heading to Hollywood Studios. Hi friends, it is the next day. My camera died, so you know, it is what it is. You didn't miss much. I didn't end up writing anything. Wait times were too long, and then turns out it was grad night for seniors and fifth grade culmination. So they were all there. It was a bit chaos, but I still had a really good time, so that was good. I did end up taking an Uber over to Hollywood Studios to meet my friends and stayed there until 10. I think we ended at 10. I walked, I think, 33,000 steps, so definitely got my steps in. Yeah, I did basically everything that I wanted to do except for Hagrid's, but I've ridden it before, so that's okay. All in all, really good day. I definitely recommend multiple days. I mean, going by myself, I could kind of zip around and get things done, but I would definitely take your time with it. There's a lot to see, a lot to do, a lot to ride, so I would definitely recommend at least 2 days. So today is my rest day. We're gonna go swimming and just kind of hang out. So there'll be more Disney vlogs in a little bit. So stay tuned, make sure you're subscribed, and I will see you guys next time.